Hey guys, in today's video, I'm going back to that package unit that had the TXV that was just completely locked down, and I'm changing the TXV. I'll leave a link at the end of the video to that video where I diagnosed it. Stay tuned, here we go. All right, we got all this hooked up. I'm just opening up my gauges here. Alright, so there's our offending TXV. I do hope I have a dryer because I didn't order one. I'm pretty sure I do. This recovery machine's real fast. Got everything recovered, recovery machine unhooked. I got this set to braze. Now we got to work on pulling these out. First, I'm just making sure that this TXV matches up, and it does. We're probably gonna get a whole new piece of copper right here. Unbraze here, here, and here. And that's probably gonna be it. That's being a little bit of a bugger. Thank you. I've got everything in place, ready to solder up, because I got so many joints really close to this TXV. I'm gonna make some effort to try to keep it cool. I got this stuff wrapped around where I'm soldering in some cool gel on the power head. Wait a minute, is that all the pressure I got? I don't have a ton of pressure, do I? Let's boost that up. Tell you what, in case I have to do this again, let's go ahead and valve that off and do like a bubble search. I'm not seeing anything. That's just nitrogen coming out. I already have my Schrader's removed. So let's start a vacuum. Make sure I got plenty of oil. Open my ballast. Yet. I like to show some microns before I close my barrels. Oh, down to 7,000. Well, it's starting to pull down quick. Those green wires. Starting to pull down quick. So hopefully this won't take too long. Get some zip ties. All right, nice and secure. Down to 700 microns. So we're getting there. It's looking like this last little bit is gonna take me a while. It's probably been between five and 10 minutes since the last time we checked that. So it's going down just slowly. Down below 600 microns. Hopefully this don't take too long. A little bit closer. Don't seem to be moving much right now, but I'm gonna give it a little more time. Getting closer. Okay, finally getting it down to 500. I've got these valved off. I don't know if you can see that, but I'm hanging out around 553. It has been there for a couple minutes now. 552. So I'm fixing to add pressure to it, recharge with what I recovered, and I'm probably gonna have to add a little bit. 551. I'm gonna go ahead and put in new Schrader's. I like to do that anytime I'm pulling a vacuum. I mean, those things are cheap, why not? Y'all hear this thing hissing on me? Uh-huh. It was actually this that was hissing on me. Alright, the moment of truth is about to come. Let's run it in cool a little bit. I did not kill the power on this thing the entire time I worked on it. All right, before, if you'll remember, the TXV was not metering, and I'll try to leave a link up here to my video where I diagnosed this. So let's watch it just for a little while. The compressor was clicking and pulling into a vacuum. It's already doing better. Let's get all this freon that's in my recovery drone out, and we may have to add a little bit. I have not added any extra refrigerant. This is it, running in cool. Super heat's a little bit high. Considering how cool it is out here, it's 64 degrees. I would say we need a little more. Let's try running it in heat here in just a second. Here we are running in heat. This subcooling is real. This temperature right here is 127. And we're not going into a vacuum. Well, that one went well. I was able to get it done in about 2.5 hours. If y'all didn't see the diagnosis on this one, I'm gonna leave a link at the end of the video. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you on the next one.